In this video, we have given that Px be a polynomial with integral coefficient such that P of minus 4 is equal to 5 and P of 5 is equal to minus 4. Then what is the maximum possible remainder when P0 is divided by 60? So first method, if Px be a polynomial with integral coefficient, then P of A minus P of B, it will be always divisible by A minus B, and we have Px with integral coefficient, so P0 minus P of minus 4, it is divisible by 0 minus minus 4, and we can say that P0 minus P of minus 4, it is divisible by 4. So 4 divides P0 minus P of minus 4, and 4 divides P0 minus P of minus 4 is 5. So P0, it will be equal to 4 times sum A plus 5, where A, it is any integer. And P of 0 minus P of 5, it is divisible by 0 minus 5. So we can say that minus 5 divides P0 minus P5, and P5 is minus 4. So minus 5 divides P0 minus P5 is minus 4, and minus 5 divides P0 plus 4. So P0, it will be equal to minus 5 times B minus 4, where B, it is any integer. And we can say that P0, it is equal to 5C minus 4, where C is equal to minus B. So P0, it is 4A plus 5, and P0 is 5C minus 4. So 4A plus 5, it is equal to 5C minus 4, and 5C minus 4A, it will be equal to 5 plus 4 is 9. And C is equal to 1 and A is equal to minus 1 is one of the solution, because 5 times 1 minus 4 times minus 1, it is 5 plus 4, that is 9. So 5 times 1 plus 4 lambda and minus 4 times minus 1 plus 5 lambda, it will be 5 plus 20 lambda plus 4 minus 20 lambda, and 20 lambda will get cancelled and it is 9. So C will be equal to 1 plus 4 lambda and A will be equal to minus 1 plus 5 lambda, where lambda it is any integer, because A and C are integer and we have P0 is equal to 5C minus 4. P0 it is equal to 5C minus 4 and P0 it is equal to 5 times C is 1 plus 4 lambda minus 4, and P0 it is equal to 5 plus 20 lambda minus 4, and P0 it is equal to 1 plus 20 lambda. So P0 it will be equal to 1, 21, 41, 61, 81, 101, 121 and so on, because lambda it is integer. So P0 mod 60 it will be equal to 1, 21, 41 and again 1, 21, 41 and again 1 and so on. So maximum possible remainder when P0 is divided by 60, it will be equal to 41, and second method, we have P of minus 4 is equal to 5 and P of 5 is equal to minus 4, and it is P minus 4 minus 5 is equal to 0, and it is P minus 4 plus minus 5 is minus 4 minus 1, that is equal to 0, and here it is P5 plus 4 is equal to 0, and P5 plus 4 is 5 minus 1, that is equal to 0. So we can say that P of x plus x minus 1 is equal to 0, 2 root of this equation, it is minus 4 and 5, because at minus 4 it is 0 and at 5 it is 0, and if fx is equal to 0, has root a and b, then fx will be equal to some constant times x minus a times x minus b. So px plus x minus 1, it will be equal to k times x plus 4 times x minus 5 times some qx, because px plus x minus 1, it may have more than 2 root. That's why we need qx. So at x is equal to 0, p 0 plus 0 minus 1, it will be equal to k times 0 plus 4 times 0 minus 5 times q 0, and p 0 minus 1, it is equal to k times 4 times minus 5 is minus 20 times q 0, and we have given that px, it is polynomial with integral coefficient. So coefficient is integer, so k and q0, they must be integer. So p0 minus 1, it is equal to some integer, suppose lambda times 20, where lambda, it is any integer. And p0, it will be equal to 20 lambda plus 1. So p0, it will be equal to 1, 21, 41, 61, 81, 101, 121, and so on. So p0 mod 60, it will be equal to 1, 21, 41, and again 1, 21, 41, and again 1, and so on. So maximum value of remainder, it is 41. So it will be 41.